Every aspect of our daily lives is dependent on energy. We use it to travel, to illuminate and heat our homes, to produce the food we eat, and so much more. Access to energy is crucial for our societies, and the way we produce and consume it can have a great impact, not only on our well-being, but also on the environment. So what does an energy system which serves us, the people, while respecting the limits of our planet, look like? The first thing to know about energy is that the source is key. Conventional sources, such as fossil fuel and coal, are contributing to climate change, and they put the environment and humans in danger. We need to replace these with sustainable energy sources, such as wind, sun, and water, which are easily renewed. Countries such as Portugal, Denmark, and Germany are already living proof that energy systems can run solely on renewable energy. Citizens can become prosumers instead of consumers. This means that they can produce, sell, store, and consume their own renewable energy. In several other European countries, we as consumers can choose a green energy provider and, with our demand, stimulate further investment in research and technology. Another important thing to keep in mind is that it's not just about quality, but also quantity. And when it comes to energy, less is better. Opting for energy-saving devices, switching them off when they are not in use, as well as general responsible use of energy can save us a lot of money. And remember, energy is everywhere, so consuming fewer products in general is beneficial for our planet. So, if it's so good, why is sustainable energy not yet the norm in Europe? Well, as much as we consumers can influence things, we still need to demand our politicians at national and EU level to take action. Firstly, our current energy production and distribution systems favor big corporations, meaning that the energy sector is highly privatized and the decision-making of setting prices, as well as production conditions, are left to a few powerful profit-seeking actors. Secondly, our energy markets are often obscure and secretive, and we as consumers are not well protected against market monopoly. With little public control on prices and a lack of funding for renovation and energy efficiency measures for older buildings, energy poverty is still a big problem in the EU. Think about this. 1 in 10 EU citizens cannot afford enough energy to cover their daily needs. Also, we are currently dependent on external actors to have enough energy. This means that tense relations with Russia, as well as with authoritarian regimes in the Middle East, can affect our energy security. If we move towards domestic and decentralized renewable production, we can ensure that we always have enough affordable energy for everyone. On top of that, we need to demand accessible and accurate information on energy efficiency of products from our politicians. For example, through proper labeling, so that we can make the best decisions for our purse and the planet. Finally, the fossil fuel industry still receives subsidies in Europe, which come in various forms such as direct funding, tax exemptions, preferential loans and guarantees from public banks, and gives them favorable access to resources, infrastructure and land. Civil society and progressive forces are already calling on the EU to phase out fossil fuel subsidies by 2020, but we still have a long way to go. So, now that you know what a sustainable energy system looks like, you can see that change is underway. But we need citizens, industries, and politicians to push for more and demand faster transformation. I hope you feel energized to bring about your own contribution.